It's not R-A-I-N, but R-E-I-G-N. It's one of those moments when the Lord woke me up in the middle of the night. I'm a school teacher. I hate you. Shouldn't be happening. We had a snowstorm, what, a week ago? 60 degrees 2 days ago? The earth is telling us what we won't hear. We're not listening. It's trying to tell us to get it together.
I hear the breeze. September, I think it was about September 9th, we started something called Life Ministries, just teaching people in music ministry. Well, about 2 days before we started, we got a call from a young lady who plays for a couple of churches on Long Island, and she said, "I need you to pray because my niece, I think it was that Saturday night, was hit by a drunk driver." They took her to the hospital. They said she was on life support. They said she would never, ever do anything again. And they told the family, "You really just, you know, people in the hospital can sometimes be a little insensitive because they just tell you, you know, you might as well just pull a plug." And for them, it's a business decision, a business transaction. And they were basically saying she's never going to regain any function. That her brain's never going to show any movement, show anything. And they were like, "Well, why don't you just pull the plug, you know, and, we don't know how long your insurance is going to cover X, Y, Z, and blah, 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 blah. But it would be better. It would be, you know, easier for her if you just pulled the plug." So they called us and they said, you know, and these were not church people, but they said, "We're going to keep talking to her like she's alive." Said, "Will you just come and pray?" So me and my wife, we went to the hospital, and my wife grabbed her by the foot because the family was talking to her relentlessly. And my wife grabbed her by the foot and began to pray, and we just began to pray. And interestingly enough, this young lady's cousins were talking to her just like she was in the room. And they were not church people at all. She was going to be okay, and they believed that she would come back 100%. And my point is, if people who don't know God can believe to that degree, what in the world is going on with us? You ought to know by now how much God is capable of. The Bible says you'll have whatever you say. You can literally speak sickness out of your own body. So I was sitting there talking to them, and they were like, "Well," you know, they were just talking to her. And I said, "Well, if you really wanted her to come back to life 100%, I said, you have to go and start speaking what the Bible says. I said, you got to start speaking words of life to her. I shall not die, but live." And I began to just tell them different scriptures. So we prayed, and then we left the hospital. A couple hours later, the uncle calls me and says, "After you said something about speaking life, it was four young men, her cousins. They were not church at all. They asked the uncle, they said, 'Can you take us down to the chapel and show us these words of life that he was talking about? Because if we learn those words of life, then we believe that she can come back and that we can speak her back into life.'" These are people who have no connection to church. They have not been in church all their lives. They've been on the street. But they got enough sense to believe what God is able to do. The Bible says he's able to do exceeding abundantly above all you can ask or think. That's not a cliche. And it's not just a nice saying. It literally can change your life if you can change what you say out of your mouth. Have I got any witnesses in the building? So they went back into a hospital room, and for days upon days, they're speaking life. So the next day after, right, they start to see her eyes start to twitch, yeah, and then they start to see her moving her neck around a little bit. So the doctor comes in, and they said, "Well, the doctor," they called and said, "Call the doctors in." The doctor said, "That's just a reflex, and if you would stop touching her, it wouldn't matter." You know, sometimes you just gotta believe what you believe, and you gotta hold on to your conviction. You've gotta know that God has you completely in his hand, no matter what circumstances may look like. Well, they kept on praying, kept on talking. Well, you know, the doctors were still saying, "Well, you know, it's just a reflex, and then, you know, soon her heart's gonna stop because her heart's getting tired, and blah, 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 whatever, whatever, whatever." So they just kept on talking to her, and then they speak in Bible. They just read straight scriptures, relentlessly, scripture after scripture after scripture after scripture, you know. So then her eyes start twitching, right? So then she opens her eyes a little bit on one side, and then her shoulder starts moving a little bit all on one. This is all on one Northside, then her toe moves, and then the doctors finally said, well, I guess, you know, something is going on. You know, and so they pulled out the machine, the brain machine, you know, because the machine that reads your brain waves had been flat. So they turned it off because it's like, nothing happened. So they turned the machine back on and they seen these little lines moving all over the place. Just moving. Well, to make a long story short, this particular day, the same young lady is doing 15 minutes on a treadmill in rehab. And she is texting me on my phone. And I said to her, I said, you know, God is going to use your testimony to go around the world and tell people what God is able to do. I said, every time you get a chance. So now here she is on Facebook writing about what God did for her, changing other people's lives from the very person that people said would never, ever function again. So I understand a doctor's diagnosis. I understand sometimes that we don't necessarily speak the faith that we should speak, or we don't hear it. The Bible says faith comes by hearing, hearing comes by the word of God. If you start speaking faith to every sick, dead, out of place, misplaced circumstance, situation, no matter what it is, forget about saying your own words, that's cute, but go straight to the Bible. Just start reading the word of God. Do you know that the entire Bible is anointed? Even the part that says such and such begat, such and such begat, such and such begat, such and such, it's still anointed. There are parts of the Bible that your mind may never understand, but just because you don't understand it, it still works anyhow, because the word of God is anointed to destroy yokes. Anybody believe that? Amen. So, I know we don't have a lot of time, but if there's anybody you want God to do something for you, if you come up to the altar, we'll pray for you now. I don't care who you are. I don't care what your circumstance is. I don't know what your situation may look like. You may be by yourself. You may be with your wife. You may be with your husband, whatever the case may be. But if you want God to do something, amen, I truly believe that God is able and that he is not a God who should lie. He is able to make his word come true. He has never failed. Has anybody ever seen God miss something in your life? Has he stepped in places that you know you couldn't step in on your own? Has God done something miraculous in your life from the first day even to now? Has he touched your family? You know, I had to turn my kids over to God a long time ago. Brianna was probably one of the easiest child out of our five. But, you know, the others made me cray. Anybody know anything about that? You know, but I'm telling you, even when I was getting calls from the school to come because my son was doing this or my other daughter was doing that or whatever the case may be, I never said, well, he's stupid or he's blah, 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 blah. Every time I went up there, I said, he's a good kid. She's a good kid. Yeah. They're going to be all right. And I made sure that my confession is what I wanted God to do, not what I saw or not what people saw. Well, that works in every circumstance and situation. If you believe and trust God, he will do exceeding abundantly above all that you ask or think. Does anybody believe it? Amen. Just stand on your feet for a minute. Come on, grab somebody by the hand right where you are. Come on.
Sick at home. they should know that kid is going to be healed. Any person that is here that took the time to come and bless your name, Lord, we know that, like I said 2 seconds ago, you are faithful and just to see the situation come through. Father God, right now, I put my blessing, your blessing, on every single musician and vocalist here, Lord. We thank you that they came. They gave from your talent that you gave them, and they blessed every single person here, Lord. We thank you that this is not a show, Lord. We thank you that nobody came here to hoop and holler, but we have this moment to invite you to be with us, Lord. We have this moment, Lord, where we can come to the altar, Lord, where we can put our burdens down, Lord. These words, these songs, these melodies, Lord, we believe they came from your throne and you're sharing them with us, Lord. We believe that every note, we believe that every voice, we believe that every scripture said is for this moment, Lord. So anyone here who does not believe, anyone here who does not believe what God has said, woe unto you. But we who believe the name of Jesus, we who believe the name of Jesus,
song in 2009. I wrote part of it in 2009 and the second part I wrote in 2011. It's been going around the world. Tell somebody every praise.
Every praise.
It's to our God. Come on, tell them.
Truly, truly.
service tonight. Awesome.
Amen.
I believe Minister David said it was more than, I'm going to say it was a tri service. A celebration. Brianna's birthday was on yesterday. One of you for coming out, all the singers enjoyed you so much, all the vocalists and the musicians, and David, we've known him for so long, he's always a blessing, amen, and the ORU students, former ORU students, the graduates, and Northside, we just appreciate you so very much. This has been an awesome time. I could hear more, but I don't have to be back here early in the morning. So I'm going to say thank you so much. We've been Minister Bratton. We're so glad to have you. But I do have to say something else before we depart. Let me tell you how we came to know Brianna. We heard, Pastor and I did. Let me apologize. Pastor's out of state tonight. Told me to stand in his place, and he wished he could be here, Pastor, and our youngest son. But somehow we heard that Brianna was, I don't know if that was the way it was or not, kind of in a place that she didn't know anybody in Tulsa. And I suppose of going to churches. So am I right that you're a friend of Keith Childress? You know Keith. And if you all about 13 years. And he was sitting right on that front pew, and God gave him many songs. Yeah. Sitting right there. Amen. So Keith, I believe, told her dad, there's a church, a little church.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Out on the north side of town.
Yeah, right.
That's where I was. And I believe that if you go there, it will be a blessing for you. And one day, our youngest son, Derek, called us and says, Mom, there's a young lady that Keith has referred to us. And I told her that maybe I can help, we can have dinner together. But then he says, you know, I'm not sure how that would look because I'm there to have dinner with a young lady that I don't know. And he said, maybe I can just buy her dinner and bring it up to your house, your old house. And I said, oh, no, you won't do that. Dinner for her. We're preparing dinner for her. Bring her over. We had never met her. So Brianna came, just as sweet as she could be. And I don't know if you know it or not, but she can talk. She's a talker. She can talk. She talked, and it seems as though we had known her forever. Such a genuine, sweet spirit. And when she left Brother David, I said, Lord, send her to us. We need her. Send her. Send her. We need her. She's a keeper. And look what the Lord has done. Amen. So glad that Brianna and Dan, thank you for bringing her up in the way that you did. We see the spirit. I mentioned Sunday, I know she's a chip off the old block, and now I know it. Thank you, David, and company for sharing. Let's give them all. mercy is everlasting and his truth endures to all generations. God's presence has been here, and everything that has been sung and said tonight, I challenge you to take it home, chew on it, let it do something for you. There's so much that is hitting me now. I'm like, whoa, I hear you, Lord. One thing was that I needed to remain. That was one major point from tonight. That's the one I'm taking home. So I want everybody to get that one word in your head now. The word that you're going to take home. Now I'm going to get a little hungry. I'm a school teacher. I can't help myself. I want you to begin to look up words that support that word. Look up scriptures, sorry, that support that word that the Lord has given you on tonight. And allow him to feed you even more. Amen. Everybody with their hands lifted. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior.